Next up, we'll have an incredibly beautiful series of photographs by Kohji Kinno, who was honored with an award as an upcoming photographer this year.
Right in this room.
In this very room, just two or three nights ago. And you'll see really compelling pictures that he's making of sports and also some beautiful photographs that he's made that kind of animate the ocean, as I understand it. You're in for a treat.
Stands on golden sand and watches the ships that go sailing somewhere beyond the sea. She's there watching for me. If I could fly like birds on high, then straight to her.
He's an amazing rising star. We're going to get to see great work from him in the future. Walter was very happy to announce him. My three-year-old wanted to call me and give me some potty talk encouragement on this. So he told me that, I don't know if I'm allowed to repeat this, peanut butter butt, go for it. So that's support if there ever was any. So our next photographer has come to this workshop a bunch of times and is somebody I know from back from the Republic of California. Lewis Kemper is based up in Sacramento, right near another one of my Zuma photographers, Renee Beyer, and he lives near the America River. And I thought it was very interesting, the title he gave to his piece, go find your wilderness, invoke it, and he had a beautiful paragraph about it. You been writing grants? No, you should. So without much further ado, he's been spending, I asked people to give me stuff that was current, so this is from the last year, but for a while he's been going out and doing, work in this area on the trails and around the river, and you'll see. It's beautiful, and I hope you like it. Here we go.
This story is about love. The woman I loved is...
There was a boy a very strange, enchanted girl. They say he wandered very far.
So it's not really halftime, we're just past that, we're getting towards the end, but being a good third quarter, I think you guys as great presenters need some more libation, you know? If I was rich, if I had gone bought today by a rich Chinese company, I would be buying beer for all of you guys. But inside industry joke. But at any rate, so the without further ado, the next piece we're gonna do, is if anybody saw today, Brian Smith gave it a really beautiful presentation and also taught a class, I think, you know, involving portraiture and stuff. And our barmaid, Tip the barmaid. And beautiful work, Louis, by the way. Thank you again. You know, one thing I really loved about his piece, I just wanted to add, is which is unique. We as photographers quite often, especially young photographers, come to you and they want to, like, talk about going to Antarctica and going to the other side of the world. Because I did conflict a bunch, get asked about going and covering war in faraway places, as I'm sure Peter does, and your brother David, and other people like us who have gone to a bunch of them. And there's a lot of great stuff in your backyard, and I think people forget about that. And so I was very taken by the geography aspect of your work, that it was very local, and you obviously breathe it and live it intensely, and those are some really cool Californians you photographed. So. On to Brian.
You were going to introduce Brian, because I don't know.
Oh, that's right. Sorry. Okay. You're totally right. Thank you for remembering. Brian Smith is an amazing photographer. Unfortunately, he's not here right now. He does beautiful portraiture. And if you read any of the great glossy magazines, you've seen his work. These incredibly gorgeous actors and actresses quite often do not show up as gorgeous as you think they are. But people like Brian go the extra mile, deal with the divas, deal with all the problems, and are able to come away with an experience that makes you feel like you are there and you want to be there with a glass of champagne. So Brian's got two beautiful pieces for us. If I say beautiful one more time, somebody can throw something at me, I guess. It's the first one in the, he has two things, the burlesque or the art and souls. Which one's first? Burlesque, good. So I dedicate this piece to Cynthia Van Roden, who helped me pick some of the music that we picked today. The last song was in honor of Bowie, who we just recently lost. And so I had to have a Bowie song in the mix and all this. So the next piece, she loves the soulfulness of this this kind of portraiture, and she helped me pick the music for it. And thank you. So without further ado, Brian Smith.
When marimba rhythms start to play, dance with me, make me sway. Like the lazy ocean hugs the shore, hold me close, sway me more. Like a flower bending in the breeze, bend with me, sway with ease. When we dance, you have a way with me. Stay with me, sway with me. Other dancers may be on the floor, dear, but my eyes will see only you. Only you have that magic technique. When we sway, I grow weak. I can hear the sound of violins long before it begins. Make me thrill as only you know how. Sway me smooth, sway me now. Dancers may be on the floor, dear, but my eyes will see only you. Only you have that magic technique. When we sway, I grow weak. I can hear the sound of violins long before it begins. Make me thrill as only you know how. Sway me smooth, sway me now. silence dies. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, darling, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you.
Elliot Erwitt is the Yogi Bear of photography. It's amazing the things that Elliot says and thinks. He was here a couple years ago when he was, as our mentor, right? And he was amazing. I assisted him when I was a young punk photographer. I guess now I'm an old punk photographer. And he always would say, he never stopped scaring me or surprising me on a daily basis. And my favorite, because I love that quote at the end that he had, and I love that Brian, you know, got some true emotion out of these people. I love the handwriting. Isn't that insane, all the different visualness to it? That alone is like quite a piece. But Elliot once said, I went to get an award in Germany. They have like their version of the Pulitzer, and they were foolish enough to honor me on something. And so I go there, and I won, and he was on the jury. And I said, thanks for voting for me. He said, I didn't vote for you. You were the only juror. How'd I win? And he said, I don't know. And so and I said, Elliot, it's good to see you. He says, yeah. And I said, and he had a tie. And I asked him why he was wearing his tie, you know, and he just said, it's Friday. I mean, it's this class. Elliot is just always has like this edge to whatever he says. Without saying much, he says a lot.